साम्य अवस्था, साम्य अवस्था वेव सत्व गुण विल बी चेंजिंग इनटू सत्व गुण, रज गुण विल बी चेंजिंग इनटू रज गुण एंड तम गुण विल बी चेंजिंग इनटू तम गुण। गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस वन ऑफ द स्कूल ऑफ इंडियन फिलोसफी, दैट इज सांख्य स्कूल। ओके, सांख्य इज वन ऑफ द ओल्डेस्ट स्कूल ऑफ इंडियन फिलोसफी। इट इज कंसीडर्ड एज एन ऑर्थोडॉक्स स्कूल ऑफ इंडियन फिलोसफी। ऑर्थोडॉक्स, व्हाई इट इज ऑर्थोडॉक्स? बिकॉज इट बिलीव्स इन द अथॉरिटी ऑफ वेद, दैट इज व्हाई इट इज ऑर्थोडॉक्स स्कूल। बट इट इज एथीस्ट स्कूल। Sankhya school is atheist school. What is atheist school? Atheist school is that do not believe in the God. Okay? It believes in Ved, that is orthodox school, but it is atheist school because they did not believe in the authority of God. Okay? Hence, they explain the entire creation of the creation of the world with the help of Prakriti and Purush. Okay, according to them, there are two independent reality. One is Prakriti. Prakriti is independent, absolute reality. At the same time, Purush is also absolute and independent reality. We can say that they are accepting two coexisting realities. Two coexisting reality. One is Prakriti, another one is Purush. Hence, they accepted two types of reality. That is why we are saying that they are dualistic realism. Two realities and they are realistic school. According to them, what is a realism? Realism means the object of knowledge. Object of knowledge. Existing independent of knower. Okay, so without our knowledge, they are existing independently. Hence, this particular school of philosophy is dualistic realism. Okay, so if anyone asks that give the introduction of Sankhya school, then you will be saying that Sankhya is orthodox school because they believe in the authority of Ved, first. Second, they are atheist school. They are atheist school. Why atheist? Because they did not believe in the authority of God. They are dualistic school. They are realistic school. And they explain the entire creation with the interplay of two mutually independent, absolute, coexisting, co-eternal reality. One is Prakriti, another one is Purush. Is it okay? This is the introduction of Sankhya. Now, we will understand what they are saying with respect to the creation or evolution of this world. Okay, so first thing about Sankhya is Prakriti. First, they describe the Prakriti, that look, Prakriti is the root cause or material cause of everything. That's why it is Pradhan. Okay, first we will understand. Okay, these are the technical term that we need to remind or we need to remember and we need to write as well. But first understand the concept that Prakriti is the root cause or material cause of this world. They are saying that entire world has come out of Prakriti. Prakriti transformed itself into the Jagat. Okay, they are saying that this particular world is already present in the this Jagat. Or this world is already present in the Prakriti and Prakriti is modified into the Jagat. So we can say that Jagat is nothing but the manifested form of Prakriti and Prakriti is unmanifested Jagat. So it is unmanifested form, it is manifested form. The only difference is with the difference with respect to form or difference with respect to the stages. This is the first stage where Jagat is present in an unmanifested form. But Prakriti is ever active. Prakriti is ever dynamic. Prakriti is ever evolving. in the form of Shakti. It is ever active, ever dynamic, all powerful, ever evolving. And because of that, Prakriti transformed itself into the Jagat. Is it clear? So Jagat is present in the Prakriti in an unmanifested form, and this is the manifestation. This is the manifested form of Prakriti. This is the unmanifested form of Jagat. You can also write this thing. So Prakriti is the root cause. Prakriti is the material cause of this world. They are describing the entire creation with the help of two types of causes. One is material cause, that someone took this material and created this particular world. So they are saying that Prakriti is the material cause. As Prakriti is ever active, ever dynamic, ever evolving, this Jagat is evolved out of Prakriti. Prakriti is the material cause. But Prakriti is Jad. Prakriti is unconscious. Okay? If Prakriti is unconscious, which means Prakriti is not realizing the objective of creation, Prakriti is not realizing the purpose of creation, or any aim of the Prakriti, or any aim of this creation, which means there must be some intelligent, there must be some conscious principle which will be realizing the objective of this creation, that is Purush. We will discuss that. So first, Prakriti is Jad, that is unconscious. Prakriti is ever active, ever dynamic, ever evolving. Prakriti is unmanifested state of all the objects in the world. Prakriti is unmanifested state. This is the manifested state, this is unmanifested state, which is avyakta. And Prakriti is the unity of Triguna, that is Sattva, Raj and Tam. They are not the attributes. Attributes can be separated from anything, but they are the part and parcel of the Prakriti. Prakriti is itself is the unity of Triguna, that is Triguna, Trigunatmak. Prakriti is Trigunatmak. So in short, you can say that Prakriti is Pradhan. That is the root cause, that is the first principle of this creation. Prakriti is Jad, which is unconscious principle. Prakriti is Shakti, that is ever evolving, ever dynamic. Okay, Prakriti is all powerful. Then Avyakt, it is unmanifested state of all the thing. It is unmanifested form of Jagat. Then Prakriti is Trigunatmak, that is, it is the unity of Triguna, that is Sattvagun, Rajagun and Tamagun. Principle, Sattvagun is principle of goodness, Rajagun is principle of energy, and Tamagun is principle of darkness. So Prakriti is the unity of Triguna. This is the first reality which is described by Sankhya school. Okay, first absolute independent coexisting reality with the Purush. Now, they described all the characteristics of Purush opposite that of the Prakriti. If Prakriti is the material cause, then there must be something which is conscious in nature. Okay, Prakriti is Jad, which is unconscious. So there must be some principle which is conscious, which is intelligent. And who is this principle? It is the Purush. So Purush is the efficient cause. Purush is the intelligent principle, because Prakriti is unconscious. So alone, unconscious principle cannot create anything in this world. Hence, intelligent principle, that is conscious principle, that is Purush, must exist along with the Prakriti if you want to justify this entire creation. Then Purush is inactive. If Prakriti is ever active, ever dynamic, it is inactive. And Purush is Trigunatmak, because Prakriti is different than that of the Purush is different than that of the Prakriti. So when Prakriti is Trigunatmak, Purush is Trigunatit. Purush is Trigunatit, that is beyond Triguna. Okay, so on the one hand there is a Prakriti, on the other hand there is a Purush. So first they described the characteristics of two independent, two absolute, two co-eternal realities which are having different characteristics. Now someone asked that how will you justify the creation when Prakriti and Purush, two are different, two, in fact not only different, these two are coexisting opposite reality which are having properties or characteristics opposite to each other. Then how come they come closer to each other and then which led to the creation of this world. Okay, so they justified that it is the teleology. Teleology means purpose. In the philosophy, purpose is known as teleology. So they gave teleological explanation of this creation, and they said that Prakriti and Purush, which are two co-existing, co-eternal, independent, absolute reality, which are having different characteristics, not only different, but are having contradictory characteristics, but they are having some purpose. On the one hand, Prakriti wants Darshanartham. On the other hand, Purush wants Kevalyartham. Okay? Prakriti wants that there must be some intelligent principle which can see the creation of the Prakriti. On the other hand, Purush, which is Nityamukta, which is Triguna Teet, which is beyond the Triguna, wants liberation. Liberation, or we can say Kevalya. So they both have their own teleology, they both have their own purpose, and that is why they are coming closer to each other. And because of that coming closer, or because of this closeness, Gunakshobh will be the point. We will discuss that. But first, discuss one more characteristics of Prakriti, which is known as Samyavastha. Samkhya school said that the original state of Prakriti, which is ever dynamic, is Samyavastha. What is Samyavastha? Samya means equilibrium. This is the equilibrium stage, or the stage where homogeneous changes are going on. Sattvagun is changing into Sattvagun, Rajgun is changing into Rajgun, and Tamgun is changing into Tamgun. In this particular state, there is no creation. There is no creation, only dissolution. That is only Pralaya Avastha. So Samya Avastha and Pralaya Avastha, we can say this is the original nature of Prakriti, original state of Prakriti. Okay. Hence, if you want the creation, if you want the manifestation of the world, if you want different evolutes of Prakriti to come out in this particular evolution, Purusha is the co-eternal reality which will come closer to the Prakriti, and that will lead to the Gunakshobh. What is Gunakshobh? That particular homogeneous changes will turns into heterogeneous changes. Okay, this is the disturbing point. You will disturb the Samyavastha of Prakriti because you want to create this entire world. And if you want to create this entire world, Samyavastha needs to be disturbed. How to disturb the Samyavastha? The presence of Purush. Okay, that is the Gunakshobh. Gunakshobh is the disturbing point, and that will lead to the Vishamavastha, that is heterogeneous changes will start taking place. That is, Sattva will change into Tam, Sattva will change into Raj, Raj Guna will change into Tam, Raj Guna will change into Sattva. The same thing, Tam Guna will change into Sattva, and Tam Guna will change into Raj, and that's how creation will start. Okay, so Prakriti in its original state, that is Samyavastha, there will be no creation. Only homogeneous changes will be going on. But if you want creation, then Prakriti needs to be disturbed. And Prakriti, as we have discussed, that Prakriti is an independent absolute reality. So that independent absolute reality cannot be disturbed by anyone. There needs an equal, coexisting, co-eternal, independent, absolute reality. Then only Prakriti can be disturbed. So they are disturbing Prakriti with the help of Purush. Okay? And why they are coming closer to each other? They gave teleological explanation of that. That is Darshanartham and Kevalyartham. Prakriti wants that there must be someone who can see, who can enjoy the evolutes of Prakriti, the creation of the Prakriti, and Purush, which is Nityamukta, which is Trigunatmak, Trigunatit, wants Kevalyartham. That is the liberation. That is why they are coming closer to each other. Basically, we are discussing Sankhyan creation or Sankhya theory of creation. Is it okay? Hence, Sankhya theory of creation is known as Sarg. Theory of creation is known as Sarg. So is it clear that Purush and Prakriti, because of they are having they have independent purpose, they have independent teleology. That is, Darshanartham and Kevalyartham are coming closer to each other. And because of that, Prakriti's Samyavastha will be disturbed. And the disturbing point is known as Gunakshob. And after Gunakshob, heterogeneous changes will start taking place and that will lead to the creation. That creation is known as Sarg. And in this particular creation, Mahat will be the first evolute will come out. Mahat is nothing but the intellect. In the creation, intellect will be the first thing that will come out. And out of intellect, because intellect is nothing but the higher level of consciousness, that intellect will lead to the creation of Ahankar. That Ahankar will transformed into Sattvic Ahankar, Rajasic Ahankar and Tamasic Ahankar. Okay? That Sattvic Ahankar will lead to the creation of Ekadash Indriya. What are Ekadash Indriya according to Sankhya school? Ekadash Indriya is nothing but Mana, 5 sense organ and 5 motor organ. Then Rajasic Ahankar will provide the dynamism in this particular creation because every creation needs some sort of energy, some sort of dynamism that will be provided by Rajasic Ahankar. And the last one will be Tamasic Ahankar. Tamasic Ahankar will lead to the creation of Tanmatras, that is 5 subtle things and 5 gross things. So basically, Sankhya school discuss one evolute, that is Mahat. Then 11 evolutes, 12, then 13, and after 13, these are 10. So basically, they discuss overall 23 evolutes of Prakriti. 23 evolutes of Prakriti along with one eternal reality which is Prakriti and one more eternal reality which is Purush. As their total number are 25 and 25 is nothing but the number. Number ko Hindi mein aur Sanskrit mein kya kehte hain? Sankhya. That is why their philosophy is known as Sankhya school. Is it clear? Okay. So again, I am repeating that Prakriti, the original point or original state of the Prakriti is Samyavastha. Samyavastha where Sattvagun will be changing into Sattvagun, Rajgun will be changing into Rajgun and Tamgun will be changing into Tamgun. In this particular state, there is no creation, only dissolution. We can say this is the Pralayavastha, this is the original state of Prakriti. But if you want to justify the creation, there must be some disturbance in the Samyavastha. And that disturbance will come only with the help of Purush. That is why they brought or they introduced another co-eternal, co-existing, independent, absolute reality which is Purush. And why they introduced Purush? They justified that introduction with the help of teleology, that is Darshanartham and Kevalyartham. Hence, Prakriti will be disturbed, which is nothing but Gunakshob. It is the disturbing point. And because of the disturbing point, those heterogeneous change will turns into homogeneous change. Homogeneous change will turn into heterogeneous change and that will lead to the creation, that is Sarg. In this particular Sarg, the first thing will come out is Mahat, that is intellect. Mahat Ahankar ko janma deta hai, Ahankar se Sattvic Ahankar and Sattvic Ahankar will lead to the creation of Ekadash Indriya. Mana, 5 sense organ, that is eyes, ears, nose, skin and tongue, 5 motor organ. That is mouth, feet, hands, anus and genitals. Okay. Rajasic Ahankar will provide the dynamism and Tamasic Ahankar will provide 5 subtle things. What are the 5 subtle things? Sound, smell, taste, sight and touch. And that will lead to the creation of 5 gross things. That is earth, air, water, fire and ether. So basically there are 23 evolutes of Prakriti. Okay, along with one absolute reality which is Prakriti and one absolute reality which is Purush. Okay, so this is the Sankhya theory of creation. One more thing, as they are saying that Prakriti इज नथिंग बट अनमैनिफेस्टेड जगत, अनमैनिफेस्टेड जगत, विच मीन्स प्रकृति इज द कॉज एंड जगत इज द इफेक्ट. हेंस वी कैन से दैट इफेक्ट इज ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट इन इट्स कॉज. यस और नो? इफेक्ट इज ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट इन इट्स कॉज. इट इज नॉट अ न्यू थिंग. इट इज ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट इन इट्स कॉज. दिस पर्टिकुलर थ्योरी इज नोन एज सत्कारवाद थ्योरी ऑफ क्रिएशन. सत्कारवाद थ्योरी ऑफ क्रिएशन. दे आर सेइंग दैट इफेक्ट इज ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट इन इट्स कॉज. सत्कारवाद थ्योरी ऑफ कॉजेशन और सत्कारवाद थ्योरी ऑफ क्रिएशन. वेयर जगत विच इज द इफेक्ट विच इज ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट इन इट्स कॉज, दैट इज प्रकृति. ओके, एंड देयर थ्योरी इज नोन एज प्रकृति परिणामवाद. प्रकृति परिणामवाद. वेयर प्रकृति इज ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग इटसेल्फ इनटू द जगत. वी विल डिस्कस द सेम थिंग इन रामानुज, वेयर वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग ब्रह्म परिणामवाद. वेयर ब्रह्म विल ट्रांसफॉर्म इटसेल्फ इनटू द जगत. ब्रह्म परिणामवाद. अकॉर्डिंग टू रामानुज, द ब्रह्म इज द कॉज एंड द इफेक्ट इज द वर्ल्ड. ओके, सो दिस इज द सांख्य थ्योरी ऑफ क्रिएशन. ओके, आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट. ऑल्दो सांख्य स्कूल इज अ बिग स्कूल. ओके, वी विल डिस्कस सम मोर कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू सांख्य, लाइक लिबरेशन, बॉन्डेज, लिबरेशन एंड सम ऑफ द क्रिटिसिज्म ऑफ सांख्य स्कूल इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. थैंक यू सो मच.